semifinal interview competition continues now, and we talk with Miss New York. 23-year-old Jennifer Gareis lives in Manhattan. She has a bachelor's degree in accounting, and in college, she was an NCAA All-American swimmer, ranked 5th in the nation. Is that right?
Yes.
How old were you when you started swimming?
Well, I started competing when I was 5 years old. Probably all of my life I've been competing, it seems. And my pinnacle was in college when I was an NCAA All-American.
What stroke?
In the butterfly.
Okay. Yeah. Now, how many hours a day would it take to get ready?
6 hours
like
a day. Every day.
You'd go in like before school?
6 o'clock in the morning practices, yes, and then again at four in the afternoon.
Wow. Now, we're in the middle of, or we're getting ready to start the Olympics here, and the question is invariably going to come up, do kids lose some of their childhood by putting that much time into an athletic event? What do you think?
Well, I do think you have to sacrifice a lot. There's a lot of hard work and perseverance, but it's the benefits definitely outweigh what you have to sacrifice. Mm-hmm.
Now, what do you think is tougher, getting ready for an NCAA swim-off or getting ready for a pageant like this?
I think they're both equally hard. They really are.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, a lot of preparation.
All right. Great. Miss New York, stand over there if you would. Jennifer Gareis. Next, we have Miss South Carolina. She is Lou Parker, a 25-year-old high school teacher from Charleston who received her master's degree from the Citadel. Now, is this the same? Yeah, thank you. It's the same Citadel that's been in the news trying to keep women out?
It sure is. I obtained my master's there, actually.
Well, now, explain this. How'd you get your degree there if this other woman can't?
Well, Shannon Faulkner is interested in being a day student and a cadet, a member of the Corps of Cadets, and I obtained my master's there, so I just went to night school. Actually, there are more women there in the graduate level as opposed to the day school. So.
Oh, I see. Okay. Now, did you ever run into any kind of prejudice from the male cadets?
Not at all. Actually, they were wonderful. Sometimes you hear that men at all military schools are kind of flirtatious, but they were absolute gentlemen every time I saw them in the halls.
Okay.
They were wonderful.
Now you're a teacher. Your mom's a teacher, right?
Yes. I teach ninth grade literature and absolutely love it.
And your mom teaches first grade?
She teaches first grade.
Hold this. Would you hold this microphone?
Okay.
Because your mom's class sent you a bunch of stuff, a bunch
yes,
of pictures.
They did.
You're going to love this.
This is absolutely wonderful.
This is wonderful. Can we get a shot of that? That's a
Which
little
one
picture.
Is this
is
one?
From Alexis, and she says, I wish you good luck. I wish you and me get married and get
Isn't
in love.
Isn't that wonderful? I
Isn't
wish
that great?
You good luck.
Well, we wish
wonderful.
You good luck, too.
Thank you, Bob.
Okay, that's Miss South Carolina, Lou Parker. Next is Miss Minnesota, Jolene Stavrakis. She's 26 years old from Burnsville. And back in the Twin Cities, she's a senior at Metropolitan State University, where she has designed her own degree, designer college degrees. Tell me about that.
Yes, it's actually my fourth school since high school, and I went there because they actually let you design your own degree, and you can use your experience and all your other education towards the degree that you design. And so I'm studying marketing and media, and I'm going to host my own cable television show on health and wellness.
Really? Really? What, if I tune into this show, what am I going to see?
Well, I'm going to have lots of different guests and talk about different subjects. I think that preventative health care is the best health care, and a lot of times we take our health for granted.
Mm-hmm.
But I think if you reduce stress and find time for exercise and eat right, all those things will help you not get diseases and not have illnesses and injuries that we face in America today.
Now, I think you said two key words here, reduce stress. Mm-hmm. You have a big audience here full of people. You have, what, 60 million people watching around the world. How are you managing your stress right now?
Well, I've actually just been studying yoga and meditation, and I think if you can find quiet time to really clear your mind and realize what's important, that it can help you tremendously, and it's helped me at the pageant, definitely.
Okay, well, don't take too much quiet time just yet, okay? You've got another hour or so to go. There she is, Miss Minnesota, Jolene Stavrakis. Next is Miss Louisiana. She's 22-year-old Shirelle Hebert of New Orleans, a full scholarship microbiology major at Louisiana State University, who plans to become a doctor someday. Now, when did you decide you wanted to be a doctor?
Well, I've always been really interested in science and medicine, so I just decided that that's what I wanted to do. But it was kind of difficult because no one in my family had gone to college. But I said, I'm going to do it, and I'm getting ready to graduate.
Was this just recently, or like when you were a kid, or what?
When I was about in eighth grade, I decided.
And what made you make that decision?
Well, I went to a doctor one day, and he talked right over my head. And I decided that day that I wasn't going to be that type of doctor. I was going to be the type of doctor who spoke to the patient and said, look, I care about you, and we're going to work through this together.
Mm-hmm. So you're going to be like a family practitioner, house
family
calls,
doctor.
All that?
Family doctor, house calls included, because I feel like sometimes people get so sick they have to go straight to the hospital. Mm-hmm. So by making house calls, I'll eliminate that process of going from the house to the hospital. I'll be the middleman.
Okay, now you're from New Orleans. Your name is Hebert, H-E-B-E-R-T. Is there Cajun in the family tree?
There sure is. Mais c'est le bon temps roulé.
That wondamous, I guarantee, that's Miss Louisiana. Go on over there if you would. Shirelle Hebert. Let's take a look at her scores. Next is Miss Missouri. She's Shelly Lehman, a 25-year-old teacher from Republic who enjoys piano and ballet. How you doing?
I'm fine, thanks.
What do you teach, Shelly?
I teach third grade.
Do you really?
Yes.
And that's, I remember when I was in third grade, pretty much every thought comes out unfiltered at that point. Don't they just pretty much say anything?
I think they do. They have a way of expressing their thoughts to you.
What's the weirdest thing a kid ever said to you?
I was doing lunch duty once, and we were passing out mayonnaise packets. And I had a little boy go, pardon me, do you have any gray poupon? And of course I didn't, but that was pretty hilarious.
Now your kid sent you a bunch of stuff too, didn't they?
Oh yes, all the time.
Like what? No, when you came to the pageant, they send you like good luck charms mm-hmm. and things. Tell me about those.
I have 28 good luck charms. They've either made them or brought them for me. And I'm wearing one tonight, so I'm very excited.
What is it?
It's a guardian angel. It was given to me before the Missouri pageant.
Oh, that's very nice. Are you superstitious?
I think so, a little.
Why not? Can't hurt, right?
Right.
Okay, that's Miss Missouri. Go on over there and take a look at your scores. Shelly Lehman. And finally, Miss Virginia. Pat Southall is from Chesapeake. 23 years old, and until recently was a special assistant to Virginia's Governor Wilder, and also the National Press photographers here covering the pageant voted you most photogenic. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Yeah, you may applaud that. Beautiful. Now, you worked for Governor Wilder?
Yes.
Right? What did you do for him?
A lot. I started working for him right after college, which was a blessing in disguise, because I didn't have a job, and I was in the Governor's Fellows Program, which is a leadership program. And from that point on, I was hired, and a blessing to stay on, and worked in press relations, did scheduling, dealt a lot with the public.
Now, wait a second. Isn't his term over with?
Yes, so I'm jobless.
Oh, you're out of a job. My gosh, so what do you want to do now?
Well, I would love to just continue to go around speaking to people about different concerns that I have, mm-hmm. what's going on, and hopefully getting to reporting and anchoring.
Oh, you're going to be a broadcaster, huh?
Yes, I would love to be one.
Okay, you know what?
Can I have your job?
You have my job? Not yet. The night is still young. Tell you what, though, we'll do. We have some tape rolling. You can do a quick audition for us.
Wow.
Take the microphone. Do you know how to do a stand-up?
Sure.
Okay, go ahead. Do a stand-up regarding the pageant. Go ahead. Take the mic.
Welcome to the 1994 Miss USA pageant, where 51 of the most beautiful and intelligent women are vying for the title of Miss USA. Please stay tuned for lots of dancing and singing and see if your winner takes home the crown tonight.
Unbelievable. Very nice job. That's Miss Virginia. Right on over there, if you would, please. Pat Southall. All right, thanks a lot, ladies. That completes our semifinal interview competition for Miss USA 1994.
Yeah, I guess I'll be getting some tips from Pat pretty soon. Why don't we see how the judges score the interview competition? Oh, I'm not surprised at all. Miss Virginia tops this particular category. Miss Louisiana fell a couple of points there, but the night's still young, and Miss South Carolina is still hanging tough. Okay, the last of the semifinal events, the evening gown competition, will be coming up in a few minutes.